The purpose of this video is to show you how you can take advantage of the automatic validation features that can be enabled when using Oxygen's Git client. I have a sample project already open in Oxygen's project view that I'll use to demonstrate the validation possibilities. Note that it is very important that the project be in a Git repository. My sample project was configured inside a Git repository ahead of time. So let's get started. First, there are a few options that need to be enabled to use the validation features. So I'll go to Options, Preferences, and I'll locate the Git Client Preferences page. And I need to select the Validate Each File Before Committing option. This enables the automatic validation when using the Git client to commit changes. And I also need to select the Validate All Files from the project's Main Files option. This option enables the validation of all the files within your project when pushing commits. Note that this second option requires main file support to be activated, and I will show you how to do that. But first, I'll select Project Options for the storage type for this preferences page. This allows me to commit and share these settings with other team members that work with the repository and project. Now I'll show you how to activate the main file support. So in the project view, I'll right-click the root node and I'll select Enable Main Files. Then, since this is a DITA project, I'll right-click my main DITA map and I'll select Add to Main Files to set my DITA map as the main file. Now I want to configure a validation scenario to create an association between my DITA map and a thorough completeness check. So I'll right-click the DITA map, select Configure Validation Scenario from the Validate submenu, and I'll select and apply the DITA map validation and completeness check scenario. Now that the association is done, all the references and structures within that DITA map will be validated whenever I try to push changes to the repository. Now I'll open a topic in my project. I'll change the tags mode so that you can see full tags along with attributes, and I'll intentionally break the image reference in this topic by changing the file type. After saving the change, I'll go to the Git staging view. I'll use this toolbar button to stage all changed files, and I'll try to commit the change. And you can see that an error was reported. I'll cancel because I don't want it to break my publishing pipeline. And I can double-click the error in the results panel to navigate to the location of the validation error. I'll go ahead and fix the problem. Then back in the Git client, I'll stage it and commit the change. And this time no problem was detected. Now the next step would be to push the commit to the repository. I'll hover over the push button on the toolbar to show you that it offers information about the committed files that need to be pushed. And back in the editor, I'll intentionally create another validation error by changing the value of an ID. Of course, there's no warning reported in the context of this topic, but if there are references to that ID from another topic, that broken reference will result in a validation error. So in the Git client, I'll stage the change, commit it, and again, there's no error reported at this stage because it doesn't validate all files in the project until I push the changes. So I'll go ahead and try to push them. And the expected error was reported now that all files were validated. This concludes the demonstration about the automatic validation features that are available when working with Oxygen's Git client. As always, thank you for watching, and we invite you to please subscribe to our various social media channels.